Welcome all to Cricket Analysis. India will once again face the problem of too many in the coming tour of South Africa starting from 26 December. So well, in today's video, we will discuss the playing 11 for the first test match. To start with, let us talk about the two openers. Now as the news came, Rohit Sharma has a small hamstring injury, so he is ruled out of the test matches. With that makes space for either of Prithvi Shaw or Mayank Agarwal. Prithvi Shaw, who was already playing for India A in South Africa for the past 1 month, looks in good form. But at the same time, Mayank Agarwal, who was in India playing against New Zealand, scored a massive 150, followed by a brilliant 65. So now with these scores, shouldn't Mayank Agarwal get a chance alongside KL Rahul? And that is why I feel Mayank Agarwal should be played at least for the first test match. Also, he has been phenomenal for India outside India. For example, in Australia, in his debut, he scored brilliant 50s. So with that coming into point, Mayank Agarwal should be the first pick. Alongside him, obviously, KL Rahul. Lokesh Rahul has been phenomenal for India in Tests and T20I this year. But mainly, Tests. His comeback against England was just amazing. What a statement he established out there. 100, followed by a 50, and great opening partnerships with Rohit Sharma. KL Rahul looks like the future of India in test matches. So KL Rahul should be the next opener. He would also be the vice captain, I feel, as Rahane was dropped as the vice captain. Now Rohit Sharma is out. So that leaves either KL Rahul or Rishabh Pant. At number 3. It should be Chateshwar Pujara. Even though he's not in his top form, India still hasn't found a capable replacement for him. Taking Virat Kohli to the number 3 position would be way too risky considering his current form. So we should continue with this test specialist, as soon he will fire like a warrior again. Number 4, the king's spot for sure. But now comes the trickiest and toughest and the most controversial spot in the team. Rahane or no Rahane? Yes, number 5. I strongly feel it is high time we drop Ajinkya Rahane. Rahane, who was recently removed as the vice captain, is showing no signs of improvement and giving one after another poor performances. There are a number of players waiting for him to leave and get a chance. So if Rahane doesn't play, who will? Will it be Hanuma Vihari, Mayank Agarwal, or Pant up the order, or Shreyas Iyer? And most probably, it will be Shreyas Iyer. Iyer has shown rays of hope for India in the middle order, and he may be the solution to India's batting problems for over 2 years now. At number 6, Rishabh Pant. Till last month, India had no other keeper than Pant in Tests, but then came Ridhiman Saha's phenomenal comeback. Still, the odds are heavily in favour of Rishabh Pant. He has been great for India in Tests till now this year. His wicket-keeping has improved, and his ability to win games single-handedly makes him selection even more sure. Now comes the bowling attack. India would ideally have gone with 3 pacers and 2 spinners had either of Akshar Patel or Ravindra Jadeja been available. But now it seems like India will play 4 seamers with Ravichandran Ashwin. And there is absolutely no doubt about the 4 seamers. Shardul Thakur, a brilliant all-rounder for India. And considering his batting form, he may be one of the key batsmen for India this series. Next up, the trio of Jasprit Bumrah, Mohammad Shami and Mohammad Siraj. Yes, Mohammad Siraj above Ishant Sharma for sure. The way Mohammad Siraj has been bowling this year and taking wicket after wicket and giving phenomenal performances against almost all top teams, he has been just a perfect combination alongside Mohammad Shami and Jasprit Bumrah. Well, that's it from today's video. Keep watching our channel. Do not forget to like, share and subscribe.